Hey everyone, in this video I'm going to show you how to create a 3D model using just one image. And the best part? You can use the model in any 3D software, including Photoshop. And the AI tool we're using is completely free and super easy to use. So let's dive right in. So the tool we're using is called Rodin, and you can access it through the Hyper 3D website. I'll drop the link in the description. Just create your account, and you'll get 5 free credits to start with. Once you're in, you'll see the option to upload your image right away. Now, there are a few ways you can create your model. You can start with just a single image, which is what I'm doing here. But if you have multiple angles of your subject, you can upload those too. It'll give you a much more accurate result. There's also a fusion option where you can upload 2 different subjects and it'll blend them into a single 3D model. It's pretty cool. But for now, I'll just upload this one image of my subject and show you how it works. Once your image is uploaded, go ahead and hit Generate. It'll take a little time, so just give it a moment to process. All right, once it's done, you'll see your 3D model right here, fully generated. Pretty cool, right? Now, on the right side, you'll find a few different tools. There's a prompt box where you can type in specific instructions if you want to fine-tune your model even more. Right below that, there are several effects you can choose from. Just pick whatever fits your style. Then, if you want to generate a fresh version with your selected prompt and effects, you can hit the redo button to regenerate the model. Once you're happy with the result, go ahead and click Confirm. This is where it'll take 0.5 credits, and that's the only time you'll be charged, just once. Hit Confirm, and it'll start processing. Now it's time to generate the material or texture for your model. You'll see an option to either modify the prompt or upload a material image if you have one. When you hover over the Generate button, you'll notice 3 settings appear. First, PBR Temperature. This controls how detailed or complex you want the texture to be. Second, Reference Image Strength. The higher it is, the more your result will match the original image. And finally, the Face Restore toggle. This will only appear if there's a visible face in your image. Turn this on if you want to preserve the original face more accurately. I'll go ahead and bump up the strength a bit and then hit Generate. Alright, texture applied. And look how well it did the job. The texture is super clean and sharp. It even perfectly picked the right materials for different parts of the subject, like the metal armor. Once you're happy with the material, you can hit Confirm. Then, to download it, just tick the PBR option, not the shader, select the GLB file format, and hit Download. Now that you've got your 3D model ready, you can use it in any 3D software. But let me quickly show you how to bring it into Photoshop. For this, you'll need Photoshop Beta and Substance 3D Viewer Beta installed. Just download them from your Creative Cloud app. Start by opening Photoshop Beta and just drag and drop your 3D model into the canvas. If you see a pop-up error, don't worry. Just make sure the Substance Viewer is also open in the background. This will resolve it. Once your model is added to Photoshop Beta, you can start editing by double-clicking on the model's thumbnail in the Layers panel. This will open it up in the Substance 3D Viewer. Now, at the bottom bar, you'll see all your control options. To rotate the model, hold the right mouse button. To pan around, use the middle mouse button. If you want to go more in-depth with editing, you'll find a bunch of useful tools and settings on the left side panel. For example, if you want to change the lighting, just head over to the Environment tab. Here, you'll find options to adjust brightness and light rotation. Tweak these to create more dynamic lighting on your model. You can also choose from built-in presets or even upload your own custom lighting setups. If you want to add a shadow on the ground, just enable the ground plane option. After that, you can adjust the rotation to match your scene. Next, under the Appearance tab, you'll find materials you can apply to your model. There's a huge variety, from fabric and leather to metal and glass. Just pick the one that fits your project. Once you're happy with the edits, click the Export to Photoshop button at the top. This will save your changes and automatically update the model inside Photoshop, as you can see here. And that's how you can easily import and edit a 3D object in Photoshop. Now, I know a lot of you ask for free and open source versions of these AI tools to use them locally on your PC. So I've got a great one for you. It's called Trellis, and you can try it out for free on the Hugging Face website. To access this tool, you'll need to create a free Hugging Face account. Don't worry. The link to both the site and the tool will be in the description. Once you're in, you can use Trellis right from your browser. First, upload the image of your model. Then, in the generation settings, you'll find options that are pretty similar to other AI tools, like how closely the 3D model should match your reference image and the quality level you want. The descriptions are super clear, so you'll know exactly what each setting does. After adjusting the settings, hit Generate, and you'll get a preview of your 3D model. If you're not satisfied, just tweak the settings and try again. Once you've got a version you like, it's time to generate the final 3D model. You'll see two quality settings here. Feel free to crank them up if you want more detailed results. Then click Extract GLB. But don't over-increase the quality, because this is a free space with a low-power GPU. I actually got an error when I tried increasing the quality too much. If you run it locally with a more powerful GPU, you can get maximum quality outputs. So I'll just decrease it a bit and generate again. It'll take a few seconds and boom, your 3D model is ready to download. Now, in terms of quality and accuracy, I'd say Rodin performs slightly better with more complex subjects. But overall, Trellis also delivers really solid results, especially considering it's open source and free to use. If you want to run Trellis locally on your PC, you can check out their GitHub page. You'll find the model files and all the instructions you need to get everything up and running. So that's it for this video. I hope you learned something new and valuable today. If you did, make sure to hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and I'll catch you in the next one.